What up, y'all? This is Tracy from Nerd Squish, and today we are talking about our third house announcement for Halloween Horror Nights 33 with Major Sweets Candy Factory. Y'all, Universal and Halloween Horror Nights is on a roll, and they mean serious business this year, because that's right, we got yet another house announcement. It's May 21st. They're just rolling through these bad boys, and it is wild. So our third house announcement for the year is Major Sweets Candy Company. And the description for this house is as follows. You've been invited to chaperone a field trip to a candy factory. But this sweet tour is about to turn sour when free samples transform the kids into candy-coated killers wielding sharpened candies. Okay, first of all, after that description, I want like a bag of sour gummy worms or some Nerds clusters. I need a little something sweet, you know what I'm saying? So this is a super, super fun concept. Now we knew this was coming, okay? We've had this little candy symbol on the last two spec maps, so we knew we were getting a sequel to the Sweet Revenge Scare Zone that they had back in 2022. For those that aren't familiar, this Scare Zone took place in the 1950s in a little small town where they have an annual Halloween party and parade, and it was sponsored by the local candy company. But that candy company, they're putting something in the candy, and it's making the kids just crazed and kill people. And this was a super fun scare zone. It was in the New York area, so they had a lot of land to work with, which I feel like this is one of the first times they've really taken that New York scare zone area and really did something with it. And a large part of that was the huge, beautiful, elaborate sets. So not only did they incorporate the tribute store into the story, you also had a judge's booth, but single-handedly, the best thing about this scare zone was the floats. Because as I said, they have an annual Halloween parade. And of course, Universal, when they need floats and props, who do they team up with? But the very best, Blaine Kern Studios out of New Orleans, Louisiana. As somebody NOLA born and raised, this just, I love it. I love walking through a scare zone or a house or anything at Universal and being able to get that glimpse of home, it just gives me the warm and fuzzies. And this was pretty extensive. We had three major floats throughout this scare zone, along with all the scare actors dressed as crazed kids and people just trying to survive the craziness. We had one float that was basically kind of mimicking the factory and the candy that's made there, one that was gargoyles and a graveyard theme, and one that was witches. And they were just beautiful. They were the real stars here. So I'm really, really hoping that these floats, or maybe some new props or floats from Blaine Kern, make it into the house that serves as a sequel to the scare zone. And overall, this scare zone, it wasn't one of my favorites, but it was a good time because it was a really great one to just kind of sit and watch the action. It had a lot of good interactions, whether it was between the scare actors or the scare actors and just guests in the park. Every time I walked into the scare zone, I saw a new character or interesting costume. It was campy, it was fun, it was colorful, and I truly think they can have a lot of fun with this concept in a house. I'm really hoping to see more of Major Sweets and his origin story in this house. I don't know if we'll get that or if they're just gonna kind of be like, hey, we're gonna set you loose in the factory and you're gonna see Willy Wonka gone wild. Not that Willy Wonka didn't go wild, because honestly, that's a horror movie. You know, it's a movie for kids or it's disguised. I don't know. Willy Wonka's terrifying. Tell me I'm wrong. So I am super, super excited for this house. I love when they have a really fun scare zone or a house and they can kind of expand the other way. I always think that's fun. You can get a new spin, a new perspective on those fun stories. What are your thoughts on this house? Do you have like a little sweet tooth just hearing about it? Let me know in the comments. I can't believe this is 2 days in a row that we have a house announcement. And I'm wondering, are we gonna get another one tomorrow? And since it seems that we're just announcing all the originals, and it also seems like we're getting more originals than IPs this year, are we gonna get an original house announcement every day this week? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday? Because hold on to your butts, it's gonna get wild around here. Mostly for me, because I'm not gonna lie, filming yesterday's video after a day of work, filming, editing, uploading, I stayed up late to get it done. I was really hoping I could come home and just relax. And then Universal was like, ha ha, hold my beer. So there it is. Those are my thoughts on the Major Suites Candy Factory house, the third house for Halloween Horror Nights 33. If you want to stay updated on all things Halloween Horror Nights, definitely subscribe to the channel because we are going to be updating you with every announcement for houses and scare zones along the way, and it's going to be a good time. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big old thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so when new videos hit the channel, you'll be notified. And as always, thank y'all for watching, and I'll catch you nerds in the fog. I want candy now.